Hello, and welcome to this year's Veterans Day program. Please stand up as we say the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please remain standing as we sing the Star Spangled Banner.
Thank you. was in the military for 21 years. I was in the United States Marine Corps. And I just want to give you a glimpse of what it was like working in the military. Some may ask, who are veterans? We're different individuals coming from different backgrounds. This picture right here is my retirement at the Pentagon. I was working in Washington, D.C. at the time. And actually, to have that retirement ceremony there, you had to actually get a special approval. My office was right next to the Secretary of Defense. As you can see, the armed forces are made up of men and women from different social and economic backgrounds. We come from all over the United States and also some out of territories. And some of you may ask, who are veterans? Well, there are individuals like this guy right here. That's me when I was 13, 16, and I think 17 years old. At the time, I had no idea that I was going to join the military, just like some of you. But one of the great things about being in armed forces is that we become like family. All of us are from different backgrounds, different parts of the United States. But one of the things that we have in common is a bond that we share together in the military. Now, I'm going to talk about the Marine Corps just a little bit. Yesterday was our birthday. Every year we celebrate our birthday. And we as Marines, we try our best to do our best at everything. We're truly a band of brothers. Semper Fidelis means always faithful in Latin. Right there, they're getting ready to go on what they call like a little hike. They're smiling now, but in about 2 hours, they probably won't be smiling so much. Just as I said, yesterday was our Marine Corps birthday, and each year we celebrate it by having a ball. You know, and sometimes people jokingly say even the Marine Corps issues you a spouse. So that's me and my wife at the Marine Corps birthday ball. So, I want to say again, happy birthday to the Marine Corps. It's 247 years, and also with our celebration, we also break out a cake each year. We recognize the oldest and youngest Marine. Well, I don't think we want to recognize the oldest and youngest individuals here today, do we? And we even have our own mascot. And you can go to most Marine Corps bases and you'll see one of our representations of our mascot. This right here is the Marine Corps' own band. They usually pay for the President of the United States and also for the Commandant of the United States Marine Corps. Thank you. Enjoy your day.
military veterans, those of us who have not served will never fully understand the sacrifices you've made, both in times of peace and of war. We will never fully understand what you were required to do or how you were able to do it. We will never fully understand the depth of your scars. But what we can offer you is this. We see you and we recognize your humanity. And we send you love that is gentle and healing. With blessings and gratitude, we ask you that you remember that you are loved. Thank you.
Jason Murphy, and I'm here to talk to you today about what it's like being in the military, what it's like to be a veteran. First of all, are there any other veterans out here today? Please stand up. pretty impressive. That's called listening. Glad you, I mean, I get it. I said stand up and you did. Good job. I didn't mean that for the veterans, but thank you very much for your service. How many of you right here have family members that are serving or have served? Let's give them a round of applause. So does anyone here, me being a history buff, anyone here know the significance of today other than it's a Veterans Day and we're giving honor to the veterans? I didn't think you knew this, so I went ahead. So 104 years ago, there was an armistice signed, which is a treaty, a ceasefire in World War I. So November 11th, 1918, there was an armistice signed on the 11th hour. It's the 11th month, 11th day, the 11th hour. There's a ceasefire to stop the war of all wars. And then in June of 1919, the official treaty, the Treaty of Versailles, was signed to end the war. The significance of today was that it used to be called Armistice Day or Remembrance Day. But in the 50s, it became what we know today as Veterans Day. So I entered the military after 2 years of college. I went in the military for eight years. My wife also did 8 years. The great thing about the military is it offers you, especially today, there's different routes today that they didn't offer us back then, but they offer now. If you don't want to go to college right out of high school, that's fine. You don't have to. You find your own path. But one of the options is the military. And all these branches offer great opportunities that will correlate to you moving into the civilian world and working. You can either work and retire, like Officer Richardson, or you can spend some time in, do your training, and come out and have a great job. You could also go in to get your education while you're there, or you can do your education afterwards. While I was in, I had a lot of great training. I met a lot of great friends. It brought up my leadership skills. And it made me the man I am today. The great thing about the military is that it continues to pay me and my family back 30 years after I've gotten out. What I mean by that, it paid for my education, it's paying for my kids' education, it also paid for me being able to buy my own home, land, or whatever. And it's also helped me get some of the best jobs in the world and live a great life. So when you see a veteran, always thank them. But something else I want you guys to think about is it all starts right here of who you are and who you're molded by. So I'd also like to go ahead and give thanks to all the teachers and all the administrators here today. So let's give them a round of applause. I know today is Veterans Day. I know it's a day for us. And yes, we appreciate it. We volunteered to do it, and it's something we did, and it's something we cherish, and it's something we're always going to remember. But don't ever forget where it all started. It started with your parents. So one more applause. Let's give it to your parents. Your teachers that are very important. Always listen to your teachers. And I see you guys do a great job. As I was watching y'all come in, you're very disciplined, and you did it the right way. So I want to thank you, McMillan Elementary, for letting me come in today to speak on some of the things that really, you know, helped build me as a man. And remember, you always have options, and the military is one of the great things to consider. Thank you very much.
Okay, we have a quick slideshow of some of the McNeil family veterans. Just give it a minute. Yeah.
for joining us.
Great job, well done. Let's give them one more round of applause as they exit.